In northwestern France, the medieval walled town of Dinant is a memorable site, possibly with the best preserved half-timbered buildings on beautiful cobblestone streets you can find. And with a great panoramic view of its river port, Dinant is a feast for the eyes. I was anxious to see it and glad we did. Hi, I'm Jim Haswell. Join Mavis and I as we visit wonderful Dinant. We enter through its big walled gate and head up to the core of its old town. Continuing down a most beautiful cobblestone street, we pass by gorgeous half-timbered buildings and one of its wall ramparts. We make our way up the wall to a vantage point overlooking their gorgeous river port below. Passing by its church, we make a stop at its old clock tower with nice views over town, and we wrap with a visit to its large market. As shown on the Bayeux tapestry, in 1065, Harold joined William the Conqueror as they battled the Duke of Brittany here in Dinant. The Duke surrendered and gave the town's keys to William. The ramparts we see now were later fortifications from the 1300s. There are 13 kilometers of walls with 10 towers still standing. Today is market day, being set up in their main parking lot, another reason why we came early to find parking. At the center of the square is a statue of Biotro de Gecla. He's a 14th century knight, native to Dinant, and was a French military hero with key victories against the English during the Hundred Years' War, and became Constable of France. A locally famous story, in 1357, Thomas of Canterbury attacked Dinant and took Biotro's brother captive. So he challenged Thomas to a duel, and after a long, tough battle in front of a large crowd in this market square, Biotro was victorious. Everywhere is a picture moment from here on, and I'm very glad the sun is out. It's still a little early for most cafes and shops. And many of these half-timbered buildings date back to the 15th century. These buildings are Dinant's oldest. Back then, property taxes were based on the square footage of the ground floor, so they expanded outward on the upper floors. Look at these beams. So cool. The one ahead was built in 1458, and this is how it looked before an unfortunate fire recently destroyed the building. This little guy had been holding it up for over 500 years. Little door up there. The street continues down to the river, but we stop here and head up to the vantage point on St. Catherine's Tower.
That's the road we drove up to go into town.
Thank you.
Down below is the beautiful port of Dinan, about 1,000 years old, connected to the English Channel by the Reims River. We'll now visit their historic 15th century clock tower for great views of Dinan.
After a number of flights, we come to stairs.
Yeah, the originals look small.
More to go.
The bell is right by my ear. There's the big bell. That thing actually does go off every 15 minutes.
Merci.
Market day traffic jam. Head down to the car.
Now for a quick preview of our next episode. Nothing is more awe-inspiring than Mont-Saint-Michel, the ultimate island hill town rising out of the bay with a cluster of medieval stone buildings and majestic towering abbey. We stroll through the charming village, taking in the impressive scenery, and enjoy a mystical evening stroll.